Do you need to keep records of a condominium or a cooperative? Well, then don't worry. If you took QuickBooks for Landlords, you would see that you already know how to keep records of these organizations because all the bookkeeping is the same. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. Bookkeeping is the same whether you are a private landlord that owns all the units or you're the governing body of a cooperative or a condominium. You still have residents who pay to live there. The governing body that collects the monthly payments is responsible for all expenses that maintain the common areas of the property and pay the common expenses. We will not discuss the legal structure of cooperatives. It's enough to say that the owners of a co-op are both leasing tenants as well as shareholders and owners of the whole building and the whole organization. The governing body is usually an elected board of directors like any other corporation. The owners of the apartments are leasing tenants, so they would go on the customer job list just like any other tenant of a landlord. Now, the board of directors can use QuickBooks for Landlords to keep records of what I just described because everything is exactly the same as we learned it here. The collected monthly fees from residents go to a central bank account. The shared property expenses and expenses that the co-op board is responsible for are paid from this bank account. The difference is kept into the difference between what you collect and what you pay, by the way, is kept in the company to pay the board and the administration for the services of managing the co-op. And the administration and the board of directors are just like the landlord regarding the management and the bookkeeping of what you would do. So you would follow these procedures exactly as you learned it in this course, pretending that the cooperative board is the landlord and all the books and records are the same. Now, both can use QuickBooks because the exact method is here in QuickBooks for Landlords. The fact that they are also shareholders would not affect the record keeping you do when managing them as tenants and residents. The shareholders' records are kept separately and do not affect the day-to-day bookkeeping necessary to manage property. Those are owner's equity type of transactions that the tax accountant or the controller or the attorney would record when someone purchased from the co-op board a new apartment or sold back to the co-op board the same apartment. But no record keeping would be necessary as far as day-to-day maintenance if one owner sold their co-op to another. Now, we will also not discuss the legal structure of details for condominiums. Basically, each unit is separately owned. The ownership agreement requires that everyone who owns a condo pay a governing body, someone who runs the place, the monthly fees for the expenses of the common areas. The governing body pays and keeps the surplus for their service or keeps it in the pool to pay future condominium expenses. The governing body is usually called the condo association, and the governing body is the same as the landlord who owns the units privately for record keeping purposes. Each owner is a resident that pays into the central bank account for their share of the common expenses, and then whoever runs the condo association then uses that money to pay the expenses of the property. So just use QuickBooks for Landlords. It doesn't matter if you're the co-op board administrator or the condo association. It's like you're the landlord collecting the monthly whatever from whoever lives there and using that money to pay the expenses to run the building. So you may well ask, if it works so well and it's so perfect for QuickBooks for Landlords, what's the only difference in the details when you have QuickBooks for condo complex or co-op instead of being the landlord? The only difference is that your chart of accounts would not show the rental income earned in the profit and loss. It would be the exact same account and the exact same idea, except the name of it would be maintenance fees charged. And then, of course, that's what would show up in the top of the profit and loss, so that you can compare on the top of the profit and loss what you charged everyone who lives there to the expense section, so you can see the difference between how much you collected in maintenance fees and what was exactly paid. Now, what you would do in order to accomplish this is, instead of putting rent due as the name of the item, you would put monthly maintenance fee as a service charge on the invoice, and you would connect it to the income account and the chart of accounts, maintenance fees charged. So it would be the same account and the same item, but instead of rental income and rent due, it's maintenance fees charged and monthly maintenance fee. And you can name it anything you want, as long as the people looking at the invoice know what they're being charged for. So the only difference is, when you make the invoice, instead of putting rent due on the invoice, you would put monthly maintenance fees, and whatever amount you would record would increase on your profit and loss the number called maintenance fees charged. Everything else is the same. So if you are the condo administration keeping records of what you collect and pay, or you're the co-op administration keeping records of what you collect and pay, QuickBooks for Landlords works perfectly.